Hi, I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV here at the Sonoma International Film Festival. You can also view these videos on our Sonoma YouTube channel. I am here with director cinematographer Cheryl Hess, who's brought a documentary short called She Got Balls to the festival. A Philadelphia meatball and gravy competition turns controversial when a rumor spreads that a vegan entry has won. Sometimes a meatball is not just a meatball. So Philadelphia itself, especially South Philly, plays a major role in your story. And what's your connection to the city?
I live in South Philly, and I've been living in that neighborhood for almost 20 years. And so it's not just a local film, but it's a hyper-local film.
Mm-hmm. And how did you come across Chef Jennifer Zavala?
I heard about the meatball controversy. It was on an article online, and I sort of filed it away as something that would be a good topic for a documentary, because I was like, oh, when I read that, I was like, oh my God, this is the most South Philly thing I've ever read.
And it actually became kind of a culture war issue, didn't it?
Yeah, it is. That's what attracted me to the subject matter, because obviously it was not really about a vegan meatball. It was about these deeper issues of the culture wars and gentrification. Mm-hmm. But I thought that would be a great lens through which to tell this story, because it had a lot of humor in it and also.
And just for clarification, she did not actually win. That was just a rumor that people had put out.
That's correct. She didn't win. It was a sort of mistaken identity, and then a rumor, and that just sort of snowballed into death threats.
And it became, so it went as far as death threats, but it became another "they're taking our city away from us" narrative.
Yes, absolutely.
How's the film played in South Philly? Especially, have you screened it at Tap Room on 19?
No, I need to do that. It did play in the Philadelphia International Film Festival, or Philadelphia Festival of World Cinema, and it was great. It was a great reaction, and some of the team meatballs were there, and team vegan meatball were there, but everybody enjoyed it.
And the old school South Philly people, do you feel like any bridges were crossed with this? In because Jennifer, a young woman of color, and these older white guys, do you feel like anybody came together over this this issue that turned out to be made up?
No.
Honest,
I mean,
unfortunate.
It's not. I mean, because they're not really looking. It's not really. If you look at the scene in the cigar shop, it's not just old white Italian guys. Mm-hmm. It's just older guys. So, I mean, I don't. It's not really, like, at least on their side, I wouldn't say it's racism. Like, the old school cigar shop guys all have a common enemy, and it's more like the gentrifiers and the hipsters coming in and changing the culture of the city. Things like they don't see, because Philly's a very friendly place, and if you've lived there for a long time. When I moved from New York, I was a little freaked out, because I'm like, look, why are people talking to me?
Not
and
like
they would
New York.
Say hello, and I'd just be like, it was really strange, but I'm like, okay, I live in this place now, so I will adapt myself to these new customs. And then I've been there for a long time, so I got used to that. So the people who are moving, you know, and it's also people have devices and they're more locked in. But I'll be sitting on my steps and people will walk by and they don't say hello. And so I feel like I'm kind of in the middle of two worlds in that way.
You've got numerous technical credits in film and television. Mm-hmm. How does this inform your directing and your editing process when you're making something like She Got Balls?
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Just the technical background, are you thinking kind of like, are you already in the editing room when you're shooting?
No, absolutely not. Like, this was definitely a challenge for editing, because this controversy happened in the past, but I was following her in the present. So in order to tell the story that happened in the past and then follow it into the present was a little bit tricky, as far as not setting up the viewer's expectations about what was going to transpire at this contest.
Right. Yeah. Right. Any plans to expand She Got Balls into a feature?
No. I feel like the story's been told.
Yeah. Well, Philadelphia is one of those, as everything becomes more the same.
Right.
Philadelphia, and specifically South Philly, is one of those very unique places that anybody who's ever been there knows what it's like.
It's so. Really friendly. Like it's just a very friendly. It's gruff and grumpy, but it's also really. It's one of the friendliest places that I've ever lived. It's really neighborly. People still know their neighbors. So I think that's the thing that people are afraid of losing is the sense of community. But I think there's just you have to figure out how to involve the new people in that community instead of just complaining and lamenting its loss or potential
loss. Yeah, absolutely. The film is She Got Balls. It's a documentary short. Director, cinematographer Cheryl Hess, thanks very much for coming and speaking with us. I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV here at the Sonoma International Film Festival.